Hey guys, today we're going to see what's new and cool inside the box of Sitecore 9.3. Sitecore 9.3 just got released on 20th November 2019 and is buzzing nowadays in the community. All the creative Sitecore enthusiasts are excited to get their hands dirty on it. Are you one of them to see what's new and cool inside the box of Sitecore 9.3? Then keep watching this video. Let's start with Sitecore Forms. First, before Sitecore 9.3, once you create any form, it's approved and ready to push live, you have to go to the content editor, find out that form in the content tree and publish that form manually. Why? In Sitecore 9.3, that step is gone. Once you create a form, it's approved and ready to push live,
you can publish the form from the form's UI.
Second, on submit, pass the form field as a URL parameters. This is one of the very useful features to the business because on the target page or the destination page, they can play around with the user given form field values and can show the personalized content. So this is a great thing. Third, forms can now use the platform bot detection to detect if the input is from the human. This eliminates the need of the annoying CAPTCHA element. I remember I created Google reCAPTCHA element a couple of years ago, which was very useful to the community. But now you don't need that because the platform bot detection will do the job for you. One last point, new elements like confirm email and file upload have been added in the Sitecore Forms. We were hearing a lot about Horizon since last couple of years. Yes, Horizon is now a part of Sitecore 9.3. Horizon will contain three modes, editing mode to create and manage your web pages, simulator to preview web pages and simulate visitor experience based on date and device, insights to see the contextual content insights of the page. Here you see Horizon in editing mode. You can update and change your content per page, navigating through your site and creating new pages using the panel on the left. You can directly see how your content will look like on devices while editing. Horizon also provides you with the opportunity to change the device while editing. Currently, we are in browser mode. We can switch to, for example, iPad mode. Let's do a small change on the page and publish to see the changes on the website. Here we go. We can see the word Horizon after Sitecore Experience platform. Horizon is a completely new way of editing a web page on the Sitecore platform. I would say it's a new experience editor. Horizon is not a part of Sitecore 9.3 installation. It's a separate module which you have to download and install it using the Windows PowerShell. I have shared the download link in the description below. If you have any questions with the installation, you can shoot out to me in the comments below. Marketing automation. There are few new features added in the marketing automation plan. For the users of the marketing automation plan, the 9.3 release provides the ability to use date and time in the criteria for the entry in the marketing automation plan. While configuring the automation plan, the marketers can use three time-driven criteria based on the certain time of the day, based on the certain day of the week, or at a given date. There is one more update, that is enhanced email templates. Yes, the out-of-the-box email templates have been modernized. New templates have been released for EXM email messages. Sitecore AI Auto Personalization. Yes, my friend. During Sitecore Symposium, Sitecore announced Sitecore AI Auto Personalization services. No need to create the user segment. Machine learning will create the user segment insights based on the analyzed data. Meaning that, select any component on the website, enable auto personalization, and add the content variant. And let the AI services deliver the best results based on the auto personalization. Sitecore Installation Assistant (SIA) is a user interface to install Sitecore on your local machine. There are a number of improvements in SIA. Installation of Solar. By default, you will get an option to install Solar 8.1.1. It is optional for you to install or not. If you already have the existing Solar version, you can still use that. If not, you can install the new one. But if you already have the existing Solar server and you plan to go with the new Solar server, make sure you change the port number. I personally, while installing Sitecore 9.3, didn't install the new Solar server. I used the existing 7.2.1. During the installation, you will get an option to install external modules like SXA. Now here, I'm not sure why Horizon is not a part of Sitecore Installation Assistant, but I'm hoping to see that in the future release. General enhancements. There are many enhancements done on the platform, but here I would like to discuss one and very useful general enhancements, that is development approaches. Earlier, before Sitecore 9.3, during the initial stage when you are with Sitecore, you have to decide which development approach you will go with, either custom, either SXA or either GSS. But with Sitecore 9.3, all the three options are open for you. You can start your website with a custom, you can build the new website on SXA on the same platform, or you can go with the GSS on the same Sitecore instance. But make sure, with great power comes great responsibility. If you do any change with the Sitecore pipelines, it will affect the other websites as well. So play safe. That's all, my friend, for this video. I hope you enjoyed the quick updates about Sitecore 9.3. There are many other updates that are on the platform. I have shared the link of the release note in the description below. Just go and check out, and don't forget to subscribe our Sitecore Journey channel. See you next time.